Good morning. Welcome to Made by Me with Grey Roots. I'm Laura, and I'm Programs Coordinator here at Grey Roots Museum and Archives. So glad you could join us today to learn about making your very own mobile. And for this mobile, the idea was to do pollinators. That's one of the things that we always see out here in the village at Grey Roots, Morrison Heritage Village, but we also see around the county. Now, the idea for this came from a blog called Made Mad and Crafts, and they just use butterflies. To make this a bit more Grey County, in your kit, you will have a few sheets of kind of flying pollinators, but also just some friendly birds. And these were created by one of our summer engagement staff, Jillian. So you'll have a Baltimore Oriole and Eastern Bluebird to choose from, but you could also do a Monarch, the question mark butterfly, and then there's some other beautiful ones. So Red Spotted Purple, an American Lady, and then Spring Azure. Sure, and say that one wrong. But there's actually a huge list that I'll send a link to with this information. So if there's any other butterflies that you're interested in, you can do that. And for the one that I'm going to do today, I've actually created some of the things that the pollinators would help pollinate. So there's a purple cone flower, and then I also have a wild bergamot or bee balm. So this is an actual plant that I got from one of my planters at home, so I wanted to bring it. So that's one of the great things about this activity is you can take your shrink art out into the wild, or you can even just grab a piece of paper and make some sketches about things that you see around your yard or just around the area when you're traveling. So for today, I'll demonstrate doing another flower, because I do have a few butterflies already pre-made, but I wanted to kind of have a look and see what else I could do with the bergamot. So again, you can do a sketch from something living. You don't have to take a snip of it and bring it inside. You can just do a sketch outside, or you can even just find a picture online and print it off to trace. So it's one of the really great things about the shrink art is because the shrink art that you have is cloudy, you can actually set it over top of something and it shows up quite well, so you can trace it. So it's a lot of fun, the different things that you can do. When you are working with the shrink art, there is the option, if you're finding that your pencil crayons or your materials aren't sticking well, definitely you could use a little piece of sandpaper and just scratch it out. But for this one, I'm going to try it without scratching and just see how it turns out. So I'm actually going to flip this over because I kind of like how this bergamot has two flowers, one on top of each other. So I'm going to try to do that on this one. And all I'm going to do is take my nicely sharpened pencil crayon. And when I look at the flower, I can see it's kind of like regular petals down at the bottom, but then up top, there's kind of like that crown that goes up. So I'm gonna do a couple layers of these, the regular type petals that are coming down. And I'm just gonna draw those quickly. And I'm gonna make them fairly nice and big because this is gonna shrink. And I'm just gonna do a nice sketch. So I got that layer. And then I'm gonna go down a little bit to do the bottom layer of flowers, and instead I might just do it a little bit bigger than the first. And then now that I have that, now I have to do those kind of crown petals as well. So I might change to a slightly different color to do those, and I'll just do quickly kind of the look of those. And with these ones, it's really great because you can definitely add layers to your pencil crayons or even your markers, and you can blend colors. It's definitely an artistic way to capture some things that you might see around your yard, But also, if you're kind of like, I don't know if I want to do like something typical, you could also create some abstract art to shrink down for your mobile. It's whatever you're interested in, whatever you kind of want your piece to look like. So I'm going to roll up the paper. So you can see I've just kind of captured the two layers of the flower, and then I have enough room that I can do a stem. So with your two sheets of shrink art, there'll be quite a few different things that you can capture. You can also use some of the scrap to create something. And I'm just gonna step off camera for just a second. Because with some of the scrap from cutting out the butterflies, I actually used it to create this very odd but very interesting piece that I shrunk down not that long ago. So you can even use the scraps, the in-between parts from the butterflies, or you could keep everything square and decorate a scene behind or beside the butterflies, whatever, you know, you're kind of interested in. Okay, so now I'm also gonna look carefully at our leaves, and they're kind of like a nice little hook, very dramatic. And so when I have some more time, I will flesh this one out, because at this point, my tray is ready for the oven. And the most important thing is to remember not to have them overlap, because then they could bake into each other. So I'm just gonna make sure everything is flat. And before we stick those in the oven and watch them shrink down, we actually have a very special visit to make into our collections. So our collection summer staff, Jacob, he found something really interesting from the collection that has to do with pollinators. So let's jump over to the collections and see what he has found.
Hello, my name is Jacob Freilich, a summer student at Grey Roots Museum and Archives, and this is our collection room. Today, I will be talking about these three artifacts, which are from our collection. The first of these artifacts is this apron, which dates to sometime between 1920 and 1950, which is between 101 to 71 years ago. It was owned and potentially made by Beatrice MacDonald, who grew up in Holland Center, Grey County, before moving to Chatsworth, Ontario after her marriage. The second of these artifacts is this black-painted silk hand fan. This hand fan was last owned by Eleanor Rickson of Owen Sound, Grey County, who passed away in 1974. The last of these artifacts is a lace butterfly. This belonged to Mrs. Arthur McGowan of Durham, Ontario, who passed away in 1997 at the age of 95. While this artifact's exact age and origin are unknown, it is made of Battenberg lace, which had been a popular material used in the 1890s and early 1900s. Based off the descriptions I have just given, it would be difficult to find something to connect these artifacts to each other aside from them being last owned in Ontario. However, when looking at them, one thing becomes apparent. They all use the design of a butterfly. Butterflies have symbolized rebirth, hope, beauty, and life, as well as many other positive themes, making them common in the use of designs for many types of different objects. However, like with these three artifacts, there was always the chance that a butterfly was simply used because it's a nice-looking design. The shared use of butterflies on these three and many other artifacts in our collection interests me, as it demonstrates how similar symbolism and designs can be found across many different types of artifacts, which can help to better understand the symbolism as well as make connections between the different artifacts. That's all I have to say for today, and I hope you enjoyed.
Wow, that was a really interesting find there in the collections. So now that we've seen something else from our collection, we're going to create, we'll see what our creations turn into in the oven. So I carefully set the oven to 300 degrees. And when we're doing this, you want to make sure you have permission to use the oven or the toaster oven. Don't use an actual toaster because that won't turn out well. You need to keep your pieces flat or as flat as possible. And you want to be able to see them, because if we don't see them, then we're not going to be able to know when they're done. So I have it at 300, like I said, and we're just going to keep an eye on it, because with this,
they're actually going to start to bend. So you're going to see the bee balm, it's starting to move, and the one butterfly, ooh, the question mark butterfly, it's starting to curl. So that's all okay. It's good. Don't worry. That's what we need to see. So once it is flat, that's when it tells us that it's ready to come out. So we're just going to watch it be very dramatically curled. And this is honestly my favorite part of the shrink art. But again, make sure you're watching it safely and that you don't get too close because it is still a hot oven. Which reminds me, I need to make sure I have my oven mitt. Because we are almost done. And all of those colors that I didn't think were too dark, because of it shrinking, it made the color so much more vibrant. So this is really amazing. So this at this point, we are waiting a little bit longer. They're still just a little curled. And, you know, just we just need a little bit of patience and then they will be ready to take out. So let's see our question mark butterfly up front. That one was the biggest one. So we're still just waiting for that one to flatten out a bit more because there's also that one in the back that's still curled up. So with any of the butterflies or pieces, the shrink art that is still kind of bent, you or an adult can carefully push with an oven mitt to kind of flatten it out. But oh, that butterfly at the back is starting to tip down a bit. So hopefully it relaxes and doesn't flip over. There we go. Perfect. So everyone else looks pretty good. We're just going to wait for that one butterfly in the back, which has magically turned purple instead of blue, but that's okay. It's always a nice surprise to see how our pieces turn out. Okay, I think that is the end of my patience. So I'm going to make sure I turn my oven off. And then I'll quickly move to the hot pad. And I'm just going to push down on that one stubborn butterfly to make it a bit flatter. So those look amazing. The sketches that Jillian did were spot on and just really nice and easy to crop or to color in and get the detail. So one thing I did forget to mention is you need to use a good size hole punch or three hole punch to create the holes on the pieces. When I was testing this out at home, I didn't have a single hole punch and didn't think to ask if we had a three hole punch. I was like, oh, I can just use a barbecue skewer. So unfortunately this bluebird is not usable because the hole shrunk so much that I can't get anything into it. So definitely use a single hole punch or a three hole punch and just use one of those holes to make it. And you just have to wait a little bit to cool down, but if we can see that just the detail, because you get to start a bit bigger, when it shrinks down, the detail is just really amazing. So we are going to move on to the mobile building part. So while those are cooling down, we're going to move on. In your package, you'll have the hoop and then some hemp. So I did this work yesterday while we were waiting for the power to come back on. But you're going to, all I did was have it in, I folded it into three pieces. And so they would be fairly equal. Of course, one is not acting equal today. And so all I did was attach it every, so like into thirds. And then I just attached it with a double knot. Because the reed is natural material and it's not too slippery, because it does have a little bit of like just natural imperfections with the reed, it does hold on pretty well. So that would be what hangs up. And then the part, the illusion cord, will be what you attach to the actual pollinators. So You got a good amount. It's kind of up to you how long you want to hang them. For my example, some of them are shorter than others. They also like to wind up with each other. But you can have them all the same length, or you could make some higher, some lower. Whatever you kind of want. You could even use a different material if you would prefer. You could add beads to it if you have some beads lying around. Whatever you want to add some beauty to it. And one of the most important things is just to remember it's an indoor mobile, not an outdoor mobile, because it will not stand up to the elements, just because we don't want your beautiful work to end up on the ground or being washed away. But if you have any questions at all, please feel free to reach out. And if you would like more information about those pollinators, I will include that in the email when I send out the link to the recording, because there are quite a few butterflies in this area, which is absolutely wonderful. So thank you for joining us today with Made by Me with Grey Roots. And don't forget, when you are done your beautiful piece of art, you can send us a picture, or if you post it online, you can tag us at #MBMGreyRoots. And I want to say thank you again for joining us, and hope you have a great day.